Hey, my name is Elvi Musica, and I have glaucoma. I was diagnosed with glaucoma in 1975. Within a year, I already knew that nothing, but absolutely nothing that was on the market then worked for my glaucoma except marijuana. When a doctor told me I would go blind if I didn't smoke marijuana, I literally questioned his sanity, seriously. That's how ignorant I was. Like most of us, ignorance blinds us. I repeat that statement because it's the motto of my life. I was going to lose my sight. It seemed inevitable because nothing else worked, and every surgery just made it worse. I had had congenital cataracts as a child, and I guess having surgeries as a child had made it so that it was easy for me to get glaucoma as a very young woman. By 1987, by the end of 87, I completely had lost my right eye, which was my better eye, to those surgeries, to where I couldn't tell if it was any light in a room or not. I mean, you close your eyes, you know if there's light or not. This was worse than that. And the depression, oh my God. Yeah, it was really a nightmare. In the medical aspect, I've been a guinea pig since the 70s when we tried everything, including Timolol, which actually did work for me for a few years. For about 2 years, I could use it, and I didn't need to smoke marijuana all the time. However, if I was exposed to it, I knew it would help me, so I did smoke it, but it was not a daily thing those couple of years. My body acclimated to it, and the pressures went up, and then it required both the marijuana and the Timoptic. And sometimes I had to stop it and change it for whatever else was available, which would work for a while. The same thing, my body acclimates to very different things, including Marinol. Marinol was a joke because that I acclimated to within about a week. My pressures were going right back up anyway. Robert Randall called me, and Robert Randall is someone who had received medical marijuana since 1976. It seems that there was a government program that grew marijuana on a yearly basis at the University of Mississippi and was at the time supplying to men. Robert Randall, who had received it since 1976, and Irvin Rosenfeld, who joined the program in 1982. But I was the third person and the first woman now to join this group of people. So they demanded that these doctors, who weren't even supposed to be discussing this with us, had really extensive medical records on us before we could join the program. We needed to prove to FDA, DEA, and NIDA that the cannabis we weren't supposed to even be trying was the most efficient, the most reliable, and the safest part of our protocol. Right now, I thought I was one of those few people for whom marijuana worked. They had me convinced I was really rare. I was just lucky it worked for me. And that was to find out how marijuana really worked, how come it was so effective. And what they discovered through this testing that I helped them with is that whether you ate marijuana or you smoked marijuana, it really did reduce the intraocular pressure, but not only through the defected tear duct that sometimes blocked the liquid in back, causing the optic nerve damage. My privilege to have this stint, being one of four Americans who today receive medical marijuana from the federal government, that privilege comes with a responsibility to educate others so that they too may maintain their sight or get out of their wheelchair with more ease, or avoid the pain that they suffer from, or have the appetite to survive the dreadful drugs that they have to take in order to beat the cancer as it is done today. That also needs to change. There's too much evidence that marijuana can really help. As it works now, I use the government cannabis to make my capsules, my oils, that I do use it. And what that means is I'm allowed to vaporize it, I'm allowed to smoke it if I want it, or I can use it as edibles. And for me, the combination of the capsules, the edibles, all of it works really fine in conjunction and maintains my pressures equally low now. I don't have a problem with high pressures these days. So yeah, we were able, with reliable doctors, with extensive medical records, that marijuana, and to all three agencies, FDA, DEA, and NIDA, the marijuana is the most efficient, the most reliable, and the safest part of our program.
Paul Palmberg, MD, PhD.
And yeah, how about that? You know?